songwriter, sometimes I just write because nobody else has written something. And Bob Dylan had fallen short on the D&D love songs, so I felt I needed to write one. So that song is on my album Troubadour, which is actually for sale here out in front for $5. I'll be playing a lot of that, actually. I put that out about a year ago. So I'll be playing a lot of that today. And this is called To the Lord. She lived happily ever after, though she never fixed her toys. Didn't see a reason once she'd stop loving the boy. She didn't have to breathe last night, in fact I think she forgot. She lost her mind in the dream she had and the change she could not stop. So go to her swiftly, go to her softly, and take it slow. There's a sunrise at the waterline, and it doesn't take to the hole. Her only regret, her only confession, she was so afraid to let go. She just wanted to hold.
She hit the interstate.
dusty New Mexico motherland that's not in Lordsburg to fill their eyes. Then their eyes met in the truck stop line, and that's where their stories collide. Into Evangeline's car, she took a deep breath, dumped a van behind some bar. They drove to White Sands, arms in the air, desert wind in their hands, grabbing all they could grab. Brand new life from this dead land. Stars never shone as bright as they did off the hood of the car that night out in Alamogordo, where the desert starts to turn white. Even turn the engines off, poured a drink and made a toast to coyotes, to white gypsum and John Wayne's ghost. That was years ago. The desert wind can erode the rocks, but as you know, they'll say love is stronger than stone out in Mescalero. Near the Otero County line, there's a 28-foot street line in Brest with a convertible parked outside.
That is the title that just makes me chuckle, which is White Gypsum and John Wayne's Ghost. And about a month ago, I wound up doing started the gig in front of one person in a little theater, which is unnerving enough. But she had been dropped off from the local retirement home because she didn't know she was probably mid 80s, and she didn't know what to expect, and she was unnerved by the fact that she was the only one in the audience. And I got through three songs, and that was my third song, and she just stood up and said, "I don't understand any of your songs," and she walked out. So I played for myself until some other people showed up, but that was, I thought, oh, I think I'm pretty mellow, but I apparently still have an edge. I can scare the old folks, I guess. So. All right. I don't think it's too early for a song about being drunk, so. It's never too early for a song about being drunk. When you hear songs today, I've been writing songs for a long time, and so if you hear a song about a relationship or a breakup or women, that was all before I got married, and I've noticed that the theme since being married for, 16 years now, there's way more liquor in my songs now. It's more about drinking than women in my songs now. So anyway, just a little factoid I wanted to point out. I always like to make these things educational. Bartender, don't hold it against me if I fall asleep at the bar. I don't normally would even come in here. I normally wouldn't fall this far.
every moment I see begins to entice me.
Song in an auto wreck year that I used to, years ago. I was the guy who went around to all the car wrecks and used to say, oh, that's a good bumper, we can sell that, and that's a good axle, we can sell that. And I was going through a terrible breakup, and I was in my head, and I was all depressed walking around looking at car wrecks. And as I was sort of like there in my little pathetic space, this red-winged blackbird flies up out of one of the cars that's in there, just like it had been inside there, flies up, almost hits me in the face, and just keeps flying, and I can hear its wings, it goes past my head. And that's why I wrote the song. This is called Sophomore Rockets.
Red-winged blackbird, telephone line, sound of wings as it flies, like soft maracas, filling up the sky. This morning, the sound of its own. We'll enjoy it, yeah, we'll take it slow. Soft maraca, keeping time as I go. Red-winged blackbird against the snow. Travel with me where I go. Soft maraca, dancing me home. Fly above me and look down. All I want is now. All I want is now. Forcing love is all I knew. Broke her heart. And it broke mine too. The soft maracas keep me steady as I move through. I never thought I'd rise from the heartache in her eyes, but soft maracas arrived just in time. Now, all I want is right now.
Good thing he didn't hit me in the face. I mean, yeah, that would have been a very different song if the bird had hit me in the eye. That's it. I feel sorry for a sport if you catch her alone. She'd probably love you in half. She floats on through like a casual ghost, like the devil in a jaunty hat. It's 4 a.m. on a Tuesday night, and work is just hours away. Your car is on the other side of town because you just had to play. She only drinks hot liquor, even if it's hot outside. Gets into the blood much quicker, that's what she believes, that's what she prescribes. Hot liquor brings a sweat to her hips. Hot liquor brings a red to her lips, to her lips. Jameson on the stove next to a percolating coffee pot. A drop of rum in a cocoa cup, hot sake shot when it's not. There's apple cider on an open fire and spiced whiskey is swirling in. Hot sugar, water, and lemon juice making Tanqueray tidies with gin. She only drinks hot liquor, even if it's hot outside. It gets into the blood much quicker, that's what she believes, that's what she prescribes. Sunday night porch like cocktails. Like during the summer, we'll have, you know, mint juleps, and she's very into finding hot. As the weather turns colder into the autumn and into the winter, we still sit on the porch, but she's making things like hot toddies and wonderful, wonderful like hot cocoa with rum chata and things like that. So. Okay. Everyone having an okay time so far? Finding what you need out there? Good. Let me just do that by applause. Everybody having a good time? Because I like cheap applause. So awesome. Awesome. Usually to get that stand-up comics talk about how they've been married for 5 years or something like that. This was written in my 30s about just being married for a long time, and I used to have these long drives back from work. I work from home now, so I'm lucky that way, but I used to have this like 40-minute commute, and invariably I would be visited by ghosts from my past on those drives, and I would get home, and it would just be, my head would be swimming in nostalgia from past experiences and girlfriends and things like that. So that's what this is about. This is about sort of being stuck in those nostalgic moments and you can't get out. It's called Helpless and Dreaming. Kicking back down pathways long since grown over past murals and tapestries depicting heady lovers. We were rolling back and forth on a bed of opportunity.
new in their bodies, in love with the friction. Hands miles in the wake of childhood's extinction. I stand here in my driveway. What does this have to do with me? And they come to me like soldiers wanting medals. Me, I'm helpless and dreaming they blow away like dust and rose petals. And dreaming. There's the one I would have died for, the one I had to lie for, some I had no time for, and some I bet the sky for. They stand here all around me, on the edge of this dream. Twice the man I know I was when I kissed them. I had no idea that all down the line I'd miss them. Just an obvious collage of my life floats around me. And they come to me like soldiers wanting medals of me. I'm helpless and dreaming. They blow away like dust and rose petals of me. And dreaming. This incessant fascination with the path I could have taken, the love I could be making, the trees I could be shaking, and the smiles I'd be faking. I've moved mountains since I looked in their eyes. The heartache's just as real as the night we said goodbye. Just another ring in the trunk of my life that grows under me. The moment lifts and I'm back home with my family, listening to the rain as it falls through the oak leaves. The lovers of a lifetime slip back soft into the scenery. They come to me like soldiers wanting medals of me. I'm helpless and dreaming. They blow away like dust and rose petals of me. I'm helpless and dreaming.
Some low E issues. And now is when I take it down to a D. So that helps anyway. This next song I did not write, but it was written by a collaborator of mine, a friend of mine that I've played with off and on for about 20 some years, a guy named Dan Hogan. And this was written when we were in a jam band and I was the drummer. So I never actually played this song on guitar until just recently, when I was working out how to do this version. And this is very, Dan is a very surreal writer, especially about 20 years ago. This is called Jonahfish. And you can kind of tell as I'm playing this, it was written by a bass player. Thank you.
to school. Learn to tie the noose. People say he's a master now. He can tie it tied a loop.
It's time for a ballad, because why not? Because I was making my set list last night, and I'd had a couple of drinks. If you're just joining me, my name is Eric Peter Schwartz. You can go to my website, epschwartz.com, where you can see all sorts of things. Tomorrow I'm doing this live streaming online concert from my basement, which is called The Man Cave, Live from the Man Cave on stageit.com, which is a fun thing that people like to come and watch for some reason. Me playing in my basement. My mom used to yell at me, get out of the basement, you'll never make anything of yourself. Wrong, Mom. I can do concerts from here in the future. Breathe promises in your hair, words like a warm, soft warden. You scattered all your hope like seeds and hoped you would grow a garden. Then you take away his love and ignore all the messages you were sending. He never saw you was ending. Sometimes you're standing on the edge and look out over the diamonds. You wonder where it all went wrong and
was ending. You pull her close when she asks you about that man. Why he doesn't come around more. She's young, she doesn't understand. I want to tell her he was weak, but you don't, because your heart has been mending. Because he ran for cover.
Again, some more cheap applause. Sound of applause. Who here has been to House on the Rock in Wisconsin? Okay, a few. If you haven't been there, I suggest you go. It's a very strange place. It was originally just a house. There was a guy named Alex Jordan, and Alex Jordan was an architect, and he was a big fanboy of Frank Lloyd Wright. So he got a chance to meet Wright, and he brought some of his drawings and some of his work to show to Wright, and as a fanboy would, look, I can do it too. And Frank Lloyd Wright, being kind of the jerk he could be, looked at his work and said, I wouldn't hire you to design a milk crate. So Alex Jordan went from fanboy to nemesis and like went out and not far from Frank Lloyd Wright's workshop and school, I think, in Spring Green, Wisconsin, he bought an outcropping of rock and built this house that was everything Frank Lloyd Wright hated. And Frank Lloyd Wright spent years trying to get the county to tear it down and all these things. And eventually it became this giant museum, and they've got like the world's largest carousel and all these strange weapons. It's, you can spend a day, just walk through it. And the whole reason I tell you this story is because the House on the Rock was the first real road trip I took with a young lady many years ago, and became the center point of our relationships. And I wrote this song about it. And the only mention of House on the Rock is the name Alex Jordan, which is the name of the song. So, again, just an educational moment that didn't really, doesn't really tell you a lot about the song. But anyway, this is called Alex Jordan.
Yeah. baby behind the wheel. Me, I'm fast asleep. We're going to see Alex Jordan at the end of the week. Followed him up the hill, looked down on the bluffs. Perfection lies in baby's eyes, and that is always enough. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. Spent the night in Edgerton, slept in separate beds. Hands intertwined, drift off on the night way, baby, done with a kiss. Drive water ski, but I failed. Spent the afternoon playing gin. Slept away the rest of the day until the family packed it in. It's all coming back to me. 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 Seems like every song I wanted to write for you had already been written, so there was nothing left for me to do except point at the radio and say, see, that's how I feel, that's how I feel. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. Wisconsin sun was falling as we turned and headed for home. Love is blind to a critical mind, so I guess I gave my heart to the road. Behind the wheel, me, I'm fast asleep. Going to see Alex Jordan at the end of the week. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back to me.
The most interesting compliments I've ever gotten was about that song. It's on my album Troubadour, which they've got up here at the counter for $5 if you want it. And in a review of it, the guy reviewing said that Alex Jordan sounded like a song that Zach Braff would monologue over at the end of Scrubs. And I thought, yeah, it does. It does. I took that as a fine compliment. And if you've never seen Scrubs, the reference is pointless. But I took that to be a very nice compliment. All right, this is a brand new song. I finished it this week. So you guys are the first audience to hear it, and which means that there's a high level of probability I might screw it up. So good for you guys. There's a trend on YouTube. If you search around YouTube long enough, and it doesn't take you very long to find it, but there are thousands and thousands of like 20-year-old girls who do cover songs on ukuleles. It's just a thing. And I wrote this song about them. It started out, it turned into a love song to sort of the genre and to the women doing it. So hopefully I get through this. It's called A Girl with a Ukulele. Christmas lights on her bedroom wall. Cherry red lips against skin like a China doll. Her shoulder tattoo and her vintage clothes. Her pin-up girl hair and the ring in her nose. She's a girl with a ukulele. A young thing with a flower behind her. Strumming away on YouTube like she's on some South Pacific Isle. Cause she knows we'd all rather be there than here. Cat's eye glasses are all the rage. She cuts her bangs like Betty Page. She prowls the night for tiki bars and tacky kitsch. Just the right vinyl album to scratch that itch.
She's a girl with a ukulele. She looks for beauty every day. And here I sit in my cynical 42, and I wish that I could see life more her way. She'd be at home, say to sailors on a beach, Pearl Harbor before the war. Blowing kisses to swabbies underneath a Hawaiian moon, and a sultry strong to remind them what they're fighting for. She's a girl with a ukulele. We should walk a thrift store mile in her shoes. We should all be more like the effervescent pixie girl, and we'd see the world shining like when it was new. My high-low girl with a ukulele,
and here's where I screw up on her.
My high-low, my girl with the ukulele, it has a weathered soul. A simple tune to bedazzle a weathered soul, and a life that's hers to change.
All right. Well, we'll keep it in. Brand new song. Thank you, guys, for being the first audience to hear. This next song, another one from my Tripwreck album, is one of those pre-marriage girlfriend breakup songs. The kind the kids love song. This particular relationship fell apart on around Calumet City and Hegwisch, which is right on the Indiana-Illinois border, which is why the term Indiana the Line comes up in this. So we've gone from Wisconsin to Indiana. And this is called Other Women and Men.
Two hearts playing for time, exhausting their options on the Indiana Line. Discuss their distress on the way back. Still in love, but they're already alone. Hold it inside until the moment breaks. Man says that's fine if that's what it takes. Woman is tired when her feelings collide. Resigns herself to tell him some other time. Complication overload. Dreams and futures fall out. They stay together, just killing time, killing time on the Indiana Line. Visions of love greet them at the door. Man knows she's sad, but he wants to talk more. But they cry and they kiss him instead. Stay as we made in bed. Compliments and let it go. They made us love and they broke the mold. Both too tired to fall again, to fall again. We're other women and men. Went to his wedding, they talk on the phone. They're not in love, but they're never alone. Complication overload. Dreams and futures fall out on the road. They stay together, just killing time.
For BATV. Do they even call it cable access anymore? I don't even know. I'm so old. I'm so wings old. I wrote the song after listening to a lot of Nebraska by Bruce Springsteen. I just wanted to write something with a lot of air and creepy stuff. If you haven't heard Nebraska by Bruce Springsteen, don't use this as a. Just go listen to it. Don't.
Drinking tonight. The moon is out and the stars are bright. It's a good time to get a little bit foggy. Good time to get a little bit foggy. Why am I not drinking tonight?
Trekish. Nice. originally as a poem 7 years ago after watching an episode of the TV show Supernatural. So don't let any songwriters tell you that, you know, it's all, well, man, I just opened myself up. But no, I was just watching Supernatural and this came to mind. So I turned it into a song about this time last year. And I'm quite a fan of it. I like it quite a bit. If I just say it to myself. Angels in the air. Television is good for some things. All right. This is just about growing up over here in Aurora and going to countless sock hops in the 80s. Friday night and my swatch is moving towards 7 o'clock. The biggest problem on my mind is whether I should pop my collar or not. In the other room, Martha Quinn is slinging music videos. Martha Quinn. It's 1986 and I've got some place to go. Still know every inch of your body.
I can still smell you on my clothes. They'll go, it'll go away with every time and age. Isn't it funny the way the fading goes? It's late at night when the demons start to rise, and I can't drink fast enough to keep up with them this time. But they'll go away with alcohol, love, and change. Isn't it funny the way the fading waves? Some memories are great, some just comfortable and safe. Neither way, I don't want them to come to play. I would gladly trade the song for a lack of pain. Isn't it funny the way the fading shades? When it's strange, the way love just melts away. Me, I fight the things I cannot change. And so I pray, and I'll wrestle with the day. Isn't it funny the way the fading lays? Somewhere in my mind, I know I'll be alright, but that doesn't help me out tonight. So I'll drink, and I'll smoke, and I'll make it all a joke. Isn't it funny the way the fading arrives? Isn't it funny the way the fading arrives?
I've got a sign-up sheet here for my email list, and I send out an email like once a month, maybe, with where I'll be playing. I'll be over here. I play oftentimes over here at Old Soul Meal, on the other side of the street over here, the other side of the road, it's the Gelato Cafe place over there. No! When are they closing? Oh, I don't have any gigs at Old Soul Meal coming up. You're kidding. Well, then my next gig is at a record store in Dickinson. Don't worry about it. Well, that's heartrending news. Greg Berner played there often as well. Well, shoot.
Sorry, I didn't mean to bum you
out. No, that's cool. That's cool. I'm all right. Consummate American wishes, make the kind of love we can only make in time.
feel like being alone. Best of condolences. All right, what time is it? Who's got the time?
11:40.
Okay, 20 minutes. Perfect. I timed this really well tonight. Today. I'm so used to playing that. Crazy, crazy motion made me lovesick on a quiet ocean. I danced under the lights for the blind, and I opened my mouth without consulting my mind. What would any romantic do when you're kissed underneath a foolish moon? Crazy, crazy lover, doesn't your heart rumble like thunder? Does it shake you and make you pretend it's not that easy to start again? And I can never ever blame you, it's just me and my foolish heart. Crazy, crazy way, our features change in the harsh light of day. In the funny way we open our eyes to reflections we don't recognize. And the way the light flooded my room, I guess I spent a night with my foolish room. Crazy, crazy lover, crazy, crazy way, crazy motion, crazy, 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 crazy way. This next song I wrote for, and am dedicating this to my son, who you can see hobbling around here on his crutch. He's been on crutches since June 19th. He's had three hip surgeries in the last 5 months. And poor kid, hopefully he'll be off by Christmas. So that's the hope. Anyway, this is for him. This is called When It's Time to Go. Beside you all the way, but in my heart of hearts, I wish you could stay. I
best thing I've ever done. Best thing I ever made. Brought sunlight to all my days.
Studio a couple of months ago recording that song, and my son was in the booth and I could hear him over the mic, and I had to do that song like 5 or 6 times, and about halfway through he goes, "Who's that about?" And I said, "It's about you." And then after a few more takes I just heard him whisper to himself, "This song is going to kill me." So, you get a 13-year-old to say that, you're doing good. It's about the very first bottle of wine I ever bought.
Circumstances, I think things are best left unbalanced. Breathing by the Bartolino next to some unused plates and napkins. But I never know where I stand. Knowledge of my footing always leads to confirmation. And I don't want confirmation. Given the way she's looking, I think it's best if I go back to my place. Friends shouldn't be dancing and leave that question hanging in the free space. But I never know where I stand, cause the offer and the offing always leads to confirmation. You want complications. Lose myself in drinking and wind up running this thing aground. I never know where to stop, cause knowledge of my limits always leads to validation. And I don't want validation. Given recent history, I think it's best if I become a hermit. Cause we'd be safe and complicated, and in the end neither one of us would deserve it.
About noon, and I really want to thank everybody who's been hanging out. listening and not throwing anything at me. That's always nice when that happens, when people don't throw things at you. Although, old vinyl, it would be nice to have throw. Well, unless you took it out of the box. Anyway, I've got old vinyl ninja thoughts in my head now. Anyway, I wrote this song. This is the song of my 30s, because I wrote it while working in many maddening cubicles. And you'll hear that in this. Another Wednesday, this cubicle feels the same, and the third cup of coffee's going down. He feels no movement now, his life with no direction. It's all the same for miles around. That's why he keeps raging in tiny places. Doesn't know how we got like this. He keeps raging, he keeps raging tiny places. Though his hands ache to make a fist. The chatter like a constant itching, causing a pain behind the eyes. He had a dream once by light and music. Now it's fighting to survive. Working poor and walking dead. He keeps raging, he keeps raging tiny places. Drinks to quiet the voices in his head. Working day ends and he's cramped and buzzing like a wasp inside a jar. You can see the movie now, his life with some nihilistic ending, a slow crane shot up from his car. I'm not going to leave you on a bummer like that, I promise. All right, this is my last song. I want to thank Steve and Kiss the Sky for having me out, and everybody for hanging out and listening. This song is a song I wrote after my Kerouac summer, my summer of 96, when me and a couple of friends piled into a car and drove west hoping to get to the Grand Canyon, and that didn't quite happen because I ripped my gas tank open in New Mexico in the Gila National Forest, and I wound up sleeping in a barn and meeting cowboys and having a drunk cowboy walk up to me with a scar over one eye and recite his poetry he's written to me in a barn. I'm telling you, it was my Kerouac summer. Anyway, the actual story takes about 3 hours to tell, so I just turned it into a song. And I will leave you with this. They've got copies of my album True Dark up there for sale for $5. I've got business cards and an email list here. If you want to sign up for my email list, check me out. I'll be around playing somewhere. This is called Nowhere Under.
So they stumble up the street.